Here's how we're rigging for buoy 10. We've got our free sliding spreader. So that way, if you hook a fish and he runs, he's not dragging your weight along. And plus, if you get a fish up near the boat and you get your sinker hung in the net, which can happen, and the salmon takes off, you won't break him off. So, but what we're doing, but we're using these rigging wires. So our line is free sliding through there. You can rig it fixed also. And then we've got our fish flash right here. We got a swivel and a snap, so we can quickly change our fish flash. You know, if we want to try a different color, which sometimes really works. And then we're running a rigging wire. This is 051 wire. It's not wimpy spinner wire. This is heavy wire. 051 wire down to a snap and a swivel. And then a leader, about a 3-foot leader behind that. So this swivel, so the rigging wire is the first portion of your leader. And then it's monofilament, of course, or fluorocarbon after that down to it. So if you do get a hang up or tangle, there's very little monofilament to untangle because the rigging wires, they won't tangle. And we're also using them as a weight dropper. So here we've got the rigging wire as our weight dropper. Now, if you're fishing an area that's snaggy, buoy 10's not, but if you're fishing an area that's snaggy, then you would, maybe on the end of your rigging wire, you'd use a smaller snap, like a number 3 snap that you might use on a maglip, for example, a medium-sized maglip for steelhead. You put that snap in here, and you straighten the snap portion out so that if you do get hung up, that snap will give way and you'll get your rig back without the sinker. So anyway, these rigging wires are new and they're the way to go. If you troll through a pot of seaweed, which can happen, it'll tangle everything up. But with these rigging wires, you can strip that stuff right off there quick. If you do get a tangle, quickly untangle because you've got very little mono to get tangled.